This is different times for us all, so I'm just wondering how he's finding, you know, the Fight Island experience, the travel, the sleep schedule, all those crazy things.
Yeah. Fight Island 어떠냐고, 그리고 자는 게 좀 힘들 거고, 먹는 거 지금 일주일 동안 어떠냐고.
자는 게 일단 너무 힘들고, 여기 야스 아일랜드 호텔은 내가 가본 것 중에 최고인 것 같습니다.
So the sleep is the hardest thing that he's actually had to address. Just flipping everything around, trying to sleep at 10 a.m. and so forth. But as far as Yaz Island, the hotel, he says it's probably the best hotels he's ever stayed in.
Yeah, no question. Yes. So what the last 11 months have been like? Because, you know, after returning, he had a lot of momentum going, and then we've had to kind of put that on pause because of everything that's happened. Has that been difficult to see that kind of career momentum slow down?
1년 동안 거의 안 싸웠으니까 수술 때문에 어떠냐고 그때 전에는 두 개 스트레스를 이겨서 그 모멘텀이 생겼는데 지금 천천히 이렇게 느려져가지고 어떻게 생각해?
근데 뭐 10개월밖에 안 됐으니까 뭐 전혀 그런 건 뭐 늘어졌다고 생각하고 있지 않고 근데 뭐 오르테가는 지금 2년 만에 나오는 건데 전혀 그 생각 안 하고 있어.
So he thinks it's been 10 months, but he says it's only been 10 months. Ortega's been 23 months, and so he doesn't think it's too big of a deal. He still thinks he has the ball rolling, the momentum's kind of shifting, and he hasn't skipped a beat.
Very nice. As you said, Ortega, the lengthy time away, I'm curious, what does that change in terms of approach or preparation? I mean, can you expect to see that same guy on tape 23 months later, or do you have to just take that all away?
오티가 2년 동안 쳤는데 그 필름 봐서 똑같은 사람인지 아니면 틀리게 나올 것 같아.
그걸 전혀 예상할 수가 없고 그리고 틀리게 나온다 하더라도 뭐 그거는 내가 이제 어떻게 대응하는지는 내가 내 실력이니까 나를 믿고 나를 믿는 것밖에 없는 것 같아.
So we already answered so many of these questions. I already knew what he was going to say, but you know, I love to say it. Yeah, we can only go off the film that we've seen of him, and I think eventually when the fight starts to open up, he is who he is. He's going to come out the way he is. He can only trust what he's prepared to do and what we've kind of planned to do. And so we're kind of expecting a different type of Ortega, but we can only guess. No one can really know how he's going to come out.
Is he happy that this is the fight that was made? I mean, there's so many great names at the top of the division. I know there's history here, but kind of not great history. So is he happy this is the fight was made, or kind of wishes maybe it had changed?
이 시합 오르테가 받은 게 행복했냐고 아니면 다른 애들하고 싸우고 싶었냐고.
사실 나는 할로웨이랑 더 싸우고 싶었는데 근데 뭐 UFC가 이 경기를 만들고 싶어했고 뭐 어쨌든 오르테가랑 뭐 해결해야 될 일이 있다고 생각을 하는 것 같아요. 뭐 근데 이거를 뭐 파이트로서 해결해야 된다는 거 자체가 조금 좀 그렇긴 하지만 어쨌든 나는 어쨌든 세계 랭킹 2위니까 내 입장에서는 나도 좋은 시합인 것 같다고.
He wanted to fight Holloway. Thought that would have been an exciting fight and matchup. The UFC wanted, you know, there's a little bit of attention and bad blood and stuff like that. So, but at the end of the day, he's happy because it's a ranking above him. And you know, we just answered another question. Is that it doesn't matter if he has to fight 3-2-1, he still has to go through the top guys in order to get to the championship, and so that's what he's prepared to do.
Could this be enough for a championship, though? I think a lot of people think if he wins, especially impressively, it's enough for a title fight.
I think somebody told us that Dana already came out and said that, you know, this is going to be the number one contention, whoever wins the shot, so hopefully he keeps his word.
Like, last thing for me, I mean, obviously the last couple performances have been so dominant performance of the night, but we've also seen so many great battles and wars. Which kind of fight does he see this one being?
그 시합 매치 두 개 전에는 KO밖에 끝났는데 요 시합은 어떻게 될 것 같아요?
일단 브라이언이 굉장히 강한 턱을 가지고 있는 선수잖아요. 뭐 할로웨이한테 300대 맞으면서도 KO 당하지 않은 거 보면 그리고 그 전 시합들도 한 번도 KO 당한 적 없고 다운된 적도 없으니까 그런 선수는 좀 굉장히 좀 내가 그거를 넉아웃 시키기 힘들지 않을까라고 생각을 하고 있어요. 근데 내 플랜은 뭐 다행히도 5라운드 내내 가는 판정으로 이기는 거니까 뭐 굳이 넉아웃 시키려고 하고 있지 않습니다.
So he said Ortega's a tough guy to knock out. He's got an unbelievable chin. He says he's never been knocked out or knocked down, I believe. And he's been hit about 300 times against Holloway, and he still didn't get dropped. And so that kind of adversary is going to be a tough guy to knock out. he's ready to go five rounds, and at the end of the day, he just wants to get that W.
I was interested, you know, obviously we know that at the beginning they were sort of friendly, then obviously the relationship between himself and Brian disintegrated. I was curious, what's his attitude towards Ortega now?
처음에 브라이언하고 사이가 좋았는데 그다음에 조금 깨지고 그다음에 지금은 사이가 어떻게
인간적으로는 사람으로서는 좋지는 않지만 선수로서는 나는 아직도 브라이언을 존경하고 있고 그의 경기를 보면서 되게 뭐 멋있다고 생각했던 적도 되게 많았고 그 경기 걔의 경기력만큼은 진짜라고 나는 생각을 하고 있어요.
So as an individual, obviously he doesn't have, you know, they're not the, on the best of terms or anything like that. But as Brian Ortega, the fighter, he respects him to the utmost. He's been a fan of him. All his fights he's watched and he was actually amazed by some of the things he's been able to accomplish. And so he's expecting that Brian Ortega as a fighter to step into that cage.
I know it's sort of old history at this point, but can he pinpoint and clarify the exact moment where the respect for Brian as a person disappeared?
브라이언가 갑자기 인정을 안 하고 저기 사람은 안 좋아하는 게 정확하게 언제인지 기억하려고
3월 달부터였죠. 뭐 그런 그 일 있고 나서는 좀 뭐 그런 선수 이런 실력 그런 MMA 파이팅 이런 스타일 이런 건 말고는 사람으로서는 조금
팔을 때렸나? 박재무
때린 거.
그게 팔을 때린가?
3월.
3월인가?
네. 그래서 그 뒤로 뭐 사과를 하고 뭐 이런 뭐 모르겠어요. 아무튼 방식이나 좀 자세하게 설명하기 어렵지만
쉽게 말해서 그때 때린 다음에.
네.
We were kind of debating if it was in August or in March, but basically just to make it easy, it's after obviously after the slap of Jay Park. Yeah.
I was curious if anything had happened before that to lead up to that particular incident. I know that they've been bouncing back and forth and stuff, but.
Yeah, I mean, he kind of addressed that before that, you know, he thought the fans wanted to hear the trash talking. That was him. Nobody else was writing that kind of stuff. But, you know, a good friend of his and his boss out there, you know, Jay Park, he got slapped. So obviously felt bad about it. He was pissed and angry about it. But I think that was a turning point of the respect as an individual. You know.
And last thing for me, does he have a theory as to why Brian's been out for so long?
브라이언이 2년 동안 왜 이렇게 오래 쉬었는지 생각해요.
일단 브라이언이 다치기도 했고 뭐 다치기 전에는 뭐 내가 알 수 있는 방법이 없죠.
그치.
뭐.
he believes that I think Brian had a couple injuries and surgeries or something like that, but other than that, he would have no idea why he's been out that long.
Many people refer to Brian Ortega as a third-round fighter. Like he starts to pick up the pace and open up in the third round. Would you agree with that assessment after watching his fights?
Brian Ortega는 원래 3라운드부터 이제 점점 세지는데 그 생각 비슷하게 생각해요.
네, 항상 마지막에 이제 역전으로 이기잖아요 시합을. 근데 뭐 아시겠지만 나도 오히려 3라운드 이후부터 난 더 세다고 생각을 하고 있고 그리고 또 이건 또 딴 얘기지만 이제 5라운드 시합을 좀 그만했어. 아니 다 이런 얘기 하지 말자. 네. 네.
거기서.
네.
Yeah, he agrees. He's won a lot of his rounds in the third round, coming back to win. But as you know, that he gets stronger in the third round as well, third, fourth, and fifth. So, he said we'll leave it at that.
I think some people in the jiu-jitsu community look at this as Brian's traditional jiu-jitsu versus yours. You have a lot of unorthodox submissions. Do you view this as sort of a unorthodox versus orthodox or traditional stylistic grappling match? If it goes to the ground,
주짓수 선수들이 다 올테가가 여기 이렇게 사이가 틀린 것 같은데 네 생각에 그게 비슷해 그 같으냐?
올테가 뭐 어떻다고?
주짓수 땅에 만약에 가면
누가 이기냐고?
뭐 그렇게
나는 근데 이거는 MMA 샵이고 주짓수랑은 완전히 다른 거라고 그리고 주짓수로만 해도 글쎄 나는 내가 이길 것 같은데.
So he said jiu-jitsu is jiu-jitsu and this is MMA, it's not really jiu-jitsu, so I mean it's really hard to say, but if it was just jiu-jitsu, he kind of hesitated and paused and said he believes he might be able to win too. But you know, it's funny because a lot of guys keep asking like the difference between Zombie's jiu-jitsu and Ortega's jiu-jitsu, but I've never heard anybody actually say what's the difference between their striking either. If they were stood for 5 minutes just striking only, I mean, no one's really asking that question, which kind of blows my mind, is that... So they're not sure that if Brian Jiu-Jitsu is better than zombies? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But that just food for thought, I guess.
Well, how do you think they compare them?
Yeah, what's
No, I mean, I think Ortega's a great fighter, no doubt, but the way he's catching his stride, if you look at his last two fights, not just offensively, but defensively. Even when he came out of the army, like when he fought Bermudez, he had a first round knockout, but he did get clipped quite a bit. The biggest thing that we cleaned up, I thought, was his footwork, head movement, not getting hit, distance and range. And I think that's what's starting to create this new 2.0 zombie.
I really like the Korean Zombie t-shirts. Do you have any plans for
다른 옷 같은 거 나올 생각이냐?
지금 계속 만들고 있고 저기 이제 이분 보여줘. 저기 이번에 나온 티셔츠를 월드 쇼핑 가능하다고.
So yeah, they're constantly coming out with new designs. That's the latest design right there. That's for sale. It's actually sold out. They sold out in an hour. I think like 4,000 copies. Sweaters, but they're actually going to do pre-orders only, and it's worldwide shipping right now.
네, 인스타그램에 들어갑니다.
If you go into his Instagram, it has a link to it. like that.
이거 꼭 써야 된다, 여기다. 꼭 이렇게 말해달라.
Yeah, so you definitely got to go into his Instagram, Korean Zombie MMA.
No promo codes or anything with your promo code?
Promo codes. No. Okay. It's all in English, too. You can go ahead and they ship worldwide.
Could you please tell us about your time in the military and why it was important?
군대 얘기할 수 있냐고 그리고 왜 그게 중요했냐고 군대 가면
우리나라 대한민국 국민 남자라면 누구나 이제 그 국방의 의무라고 하거든요 나라에 무조건 가야 된다는 그게 있어서 뭐 나도 뭐 비록 그 오피스에서 일했지만 무릎이랑 아니 어깨랑 다 다쳐가지고 그래도 당연히 다른 사람들도 다 하는 거를 나도 공평하게 같이 해야 된다고 생각을 했고 좀 늦게 가긴 했지만 어쨌든 네 그렇죠 뭐 당연히 해야 되는 거예요 한국 사람이라면.
In Korea, every male actually has to go. It's mandatory, so there wasn't really a choice in it. But he felt like he was obligated that every man before him has served in generations, and so he went a little bit later. And given that he had a lot of surgeries coming off the Aldo fight and so forth, so he got to work in an office. But he did serve, and he is proud to serve his country.
Has Reebok ever approached you to make a shirt with you, considering how popular your previous ones were?
리버크도 들어서 뚜리만 만들고 싶은다고 한적이냐고
리버크에도 이거 디자인이 있는데 근데 뭐 그거를 약간 프로모션을 잘 안 하더라고요.
Reebok actually does have a zombie shirt. They just don't promote it for some reason. He doesn't know why. I didn't know that either.
But they didn't approach you with like their previous designs have been so popular. Do they ever want your input on?
걔네들이 너한테 와서 네가 어떻게 모양을 만들어주고 싶은지 그런 적이 없네.
그런 걸 물어보지도 않았고 그리고 그런 얘기를 좀 해줬으면 좋았는데 그리고 리복이랑 저도 뭐 스폰서십 계약을 하고 싶었던 적이 있었는데 리복에선 나한테 관심이 없었던 것 같아요.
So no, they never approached us, asked for any inputs or anything like that. He wished they did because he wanted to be sponsored by Reebok, but obviously they didn't have any interest in him, so...
Stupid.
Yeah, I think so, right? He's one of the biggest faces in Asia and, you know, bigger name in the U.S., I think. So.
Has he started breaking down Volkanovski yet?
I'm sure he has. He's a student in the game. We have for sure. Volkanovski 공부해봤냐고.
아니, 지금 아예 생각 안 하고 있어요, 완전히.
He's not thinking about Volkanovski right now.
What about Zabit?
Zabit은
나 자빗이랑도 하고 싶었다고. 근데 그 UFC에서 계속 오르테가만 해야 된다고. 그 야이르랑 자빗이랑 안 하기로 했을 때 사실 내가 자빗이랑 하고 싶다고 이제 얘기를 했는데 UFC에서 안 된다고 얘기를 했었어.
So he wanted to fight Zabit as well, but then the UFC just kept on saying Ortega, 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 and then when Ortega and Yair, when they weren't, Yair and Zabit, when they weren't supposed to go, that he actually wanted to jump in and fight Zabit, and they said Ortega, 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 so you know how that goes.
Thank you.
Is that possibly the next fight for you? Is that something you looking, someone you looking to fight next?
잡으시냐고?
아니 다음 시합 계약을 써. 근데 그건 말이 안 돼.
근데 말이 안 돼. 내가 이기면.
Well, yeah, if he wins, he's gonna get the title shot. So.
Do you believe Volkanovski beat Max in the previous fight?
볼카노스키가 그 이긴 것 같냐고 할로웨이.
저는 할로웨이가 이겼다고 생각을 하고 있는데 이거를 트래시 토크라고 생각하면 안 된다고 내 생각이라고.
So this isn't trash talking just to make it clear, but he thought that Holloway won that second fight.
When were the foundations for Korean Zombie 2.0 born? Were there any lessons from the military that he's kept today, whether they checked him as a fighter or a man?
Well, that was just me stating that it was a 2.0 since he started training at Fight Ready with us. But I think you'll see a lot of difference in his footwork, his pop, his hand speed, his wrestling, all the way down to his jiu-jitsu, and you know, just his physique that he's been working with our strength and conditioning coach, Chad Ek.
Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
$146 for Thomas Almeida. $146 for Jonathan Martinez. $171 for Claudio Silva. $171 for James Krause. $206 for Jimmy Crute. $206 for Modestus Bukauskas. $126 for Caitlin Chukagian. $126 for Jessica Andrade. $146 for Brian Ortega. $146 for Chan Sung Jung.